Hello, I'm just gonna make a little explanation video about the pulse width modulation, the difference between the 8-bit and the 12-bit pulse width modulation, and how to adjust so the one you choose in the menu actually matches the one in the output header here. Right now it's all set up for 8-bit, and the 12-bit are here, but you can bypass the little bridges that are there. You can, for example, cut the one. Let me try to cut the first one. You can see that's the first one there. I'll have to cut a little trace here, and then I can solder the next two pins to have the 12-bit output here. Let me pause it and cut it. I'll show you how to. Okay, so I did a little cut. I had to go with a little magnifying glass to do it. Right now it's cut. You can see the next ones, they have a little line there in the middle of the two pads on the left. This one doesn't have anything. It's clean, so you can see clearly three pads not too connected, as you can see the rest here. And I had the output connected on the oscilloscope, and I don't see pulses there anymore. Now if you want to test it, let's see, let's switch to 12 pulse modulation. Let's see, I have here, let me put it on low, and let's sort together the two other pins. Let's see if we get, yeah, you can see the pulse here. So all you have to do is to solder that little pins there, the other two ones, so you can get the 12-bit resolution on that header, the external one I have here. Let me solder it. Okay, so I did quickly a solder, just a little dot. I'll zoom in so you can see how it looks like. So you can see I put a little dot there. There's some overflow on the header next to it, but it's not touching. Actually, there's a solder on the two pins only, not the three. As you can see here, it still works fine. Let me change the pulse width position. And that's, you know, that's correct because you can see the 1.6 kHz. That's the frequency for the 12-bit. It has to use lower resolution, so frequency, so you can get the higher resolution pulses measured. The clear path motors can read this frequency fine. 1.6 kHz, so it can take advantage of the whole 12-bit resolution. So that's pretty much about it. Now, if you don't want to do this little work here, you know, cut, trace, and solder, you can always use a pin heater and just solder it on the 6-pin here. Let me solder it. Actually, I'm just gonna place it there. Okay. Strong enough, and so I'm just gonna move the probe here so you can see it still works fine from there. You can just use these pins for the pulse width modulation, so it will be for the first mode will be the pin one here, and the out one and out two on that channel. So you can use combination of one wire from here or two from there if you don't want to do all this cut, trace, and solder process. I mean, you can do it later for more permanent, or if you want to do it single connector for everything. Right, thanks for watching.